guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a February favorites video. I've got things from all over the place. I've got some beauty, I've got some tech stuff, I've got even a YouTube channel that I have been loving. So let's jump into it. I'm going to start out with my favorite thing, beauty products. My first favorite of the month is this IGK Good Behavior Spirulina Protein Smoothing Spray. I discovered this through, you know, those VIB point things when you check out at Sephora. How many times do you get those and you're like, oh, this product sucks, I'm never gonna use it? I am obsessed with this though. Like, usually those things never work out for me, and this blew my socks off. Who says that? I say that apparently. I used to be obsessed with getting the Brazilian blowouts, and I never found something that quite gave me that same smooth look that a Brazilian blowout would. It was just such a breeze coming out of the shower, and your hair was like so straight and sleek and smooth. When I would get the Brazilian done, your hair was so smooth and sleek that even your baby hairs would just be like sticking straight up because everything was so sleek and smooth. If you have wavy hair, you know what I'm talking about, like around your face, like at your baby hairs basically, you get these like curly spots that you can't really get easily with a round brush or with a flat iron, and during the day those just start to curl up. But this gives you those straight baby hairs. It also protects your hair for up to 450 degrees, so it's a heat protectant. I like the way it smells. A lot of people said it smells like bug spray, but I just think it smells like sweet yumminess, and I really like it. The next product I want to talk about is the Essie Gel Couture Nail Polish. I usually love cheap nail polishes. I don't understand why I would spend $12.50 for a nail polish when I could spend $5 for a nail polish that I really like. My go-to is usually the Sally Hansen Quick Drying Nail Polish, and that's like $5. I've been using it for years. I still love it. But now that I've used this $12.50 nail polish, I can see a difference. This just stays shiny for a way longer period of time than my cheap nail polishes do. I don't know if it's because it's the gel couture, and this, you don't have to like do a base coat and then do a top coat with the UV. You kind of just use this as a regular nail polish, and it comes off with regular nail polish remover because ain't nobody got time to put the foils around their things. It takes way too long. Now that I'm using it, I do notice that my nails stay shinier and less chipped for a longer period of time than when I use my cheap nail polish. I'd hate to admit it. My next favorite of the month is this Gente Bleu lip liner in the color Spice. I caught this like a year ago in a BoxyCharm, and I recently started using this. I might have mentioned it actually previously in a monthly favorites. I've just been using it pretty much every day. I'm wearing it today. It's just a super natural color, and I've had a hard time finding lip liners that I really like with my skin tone. Again, it's just the perfect pinky nude. This looks a lot, on my lips it looks a lot less orange, but that's what the swatch looks like. It looks really, really natural and kind of goes with everything. Going actually into some fragrance, the Ariana Grande Cloud Perfume. I have the tiny rollerball one, and I liked it so much. This is my second bottle, and I never do that usually with fragrance. I'm really, really picky with fragrances. Usually I spray them on me and I'm like, oh, this smells like either grandmother's or it's like making me nauseous. And if you know what I mean by like the grandmother floral scent, I'm not into that. If you like yummy, like cozy, sweet scents, this is for you. You have to try it. A ton of people talk about it online because apparently it's a dupe for Baccarat Rouge, like a $500 perfume. Oh my God, who would spend $500 on a perfume? Ah, that sounds like living the life. I love it for every day. It's not so sickeningly sweet that you can't wear it during the summertime, which is like my other go-to is Dior Hypnotic Poison. And I can find that that can be pretty heavy in the summertime, but this one is great for everyday use. And again, it's just like a really great, easy to wear, sweet smelling scent. My next favorite is the Mario Badescu Drying Lotion. I've been using this on and off for a few years now. Recently I had a couple of pimples pop up, and I put this on at nighttime before I go to bed. And when I wake up, it really cuts the pimple juiciness in half. Like, you wake up and you can see that the pimple has been flattened and the redness has subsided. I have super sensitive skin, and I don't find that this makes my pimples worse or does anything weird with my skin. It's pretty affordable too. It's $17.99 and it'll last you a really, really long time. Moving into some tech stuff, I have been loving my new Casetify case. They sent over a couple of different cases, and do you know when you see something and it just like, it speaks to your soul? Honestly, I need to stop using that phrase, but like when you see something and it's just so you that it just like makes you so happy and you can't stop looking at it and you need it in your life, that's how this case makes you feel. I love the red lips, and the other case that they sent me, is like my initials on a bright red case with some old English font. And I just love, love, love this pattern. It's so cute. I love the contrast with the black iPhone background. And they have so many cases to choose from. It's a really protective, so far it seems like a really protective, sturdy case. I dropped my phone a ton and no cracks. So love that. I love a cute case that is protective at the same time. My next tech favorite is this iPad case that I got from Zugu. It is so sturdy. I really needed a new iPad case. And I, every night when I cook, I watch shows on my iPad. And something I've noticed is that my iPad gets really disgusting and dirty when I'm cooking because like things get on the monitor when I'm stirring stuff because it's on the counter. So what I love about this is you can actually put it on your fridge as a magnet. It's also really hefty. So I think if you drop your iPad, like you're good, but thankfully I have not dropped my iPad. Oh my gosh, knock on wood, could you imagine? And my last favorite of the month is Caroline Gervin workout videos on YouTube. I am obsessed with her channel. If you guys work out at home, you know the struggle of like, am I challenging myself? Is this workout hard enough? I really was having a hard time counting my reps and not really like following through with tracking them. So these workout videos just make it so, so simple and you are challenged every single time. I like to do the hour full body workouts like 4 times a week to really make sure that I'm hitting all the points of my body. But if you wanna like train your booty one day, your legs one day, your abs one day, your arms one day, like she's got the video for you and they kind of go by really, really quickly and you feel like you worked out afterwards. All right, guys, those are all of my favorites for the month. Thank you so much for watching. What have you been loving this month? Let me know in the comment section below because I'd love to check it out. Thanks so much for watching, you guys, and I will see you next time. Bye. What is this?